I'll read at least about 3 minutes. Could you please listen? And not talking, please. Can you do that? Okay, thank you. Okay, it's page 40 and 41 of this book. If you're interested, you can continue reading. So I'll read page 40. She met my eyes, and the flood of memories came back to me. All the weird, scary things that had ever happened to me, some of which I've tried to forget. During third grade, a man in a black trench coat had stopped me on the playground. When the teacher threatened to call the police, he went away growling, but no one believed me. When I told them that under the broad brim hat, the man had only had one eye right in the middle of his head. Before that, a really early memory, I was in a preschool, and a teacher accidentally put me for a nap in a cot, and a snake has slithered into. My mom screamed when she came to pick me up and found me playing with a limp, scaly rope, and somehow I managed to strangle to death with my mitty toddler hands. In every single school, something creepy had happened, something unsafe, and I was forced to move. I knew I should tell my mom about the old lady at the food stand and Mrs. Dodds at the art museum, about my weird hallucination that I had slimed my maths teacher into dust with a sword. But I couldn't make myself to tell her. I have a strange feeling that the news would end up our trip to Mundog, and I didn't want that. I tried to keep you as close as to me as I could, my mom said. They told me that it was a mistake, but it was the only thing, the only option, Percy, the place your dad wanted to send you, and I just can't stand to do it. My father wanted me to go to a special school, not a special school, she said softly, a summer camp. My head was spinning. Why would my dad, who hadn't even stayed around long enough to see me born, talk to my mom about summer camp? And if it was so important, why hadn't she ever mentioned it before? I'm sorry, Percy, she said, seeing in the eye, but I couldn't talk about it. I couldn't send you to that place. I might end up saying goodbye to you for good. For good? But if it's only a summer camp, she turned towards the fire, and I knew from her expression that if I had asked her any more questions, she would start to cry. That night, I have a vivid dream. It was stormy on the beach, and two beautiful animals, a white horse and a golden eagle, were trying to kill each other on the edge of the surf. The eagle swooped down and slashed the horse's muzzle with his huge talons. The horse reeled up and kicked at the eagle's wings. As they fought, the ground rumbled, and a monstrous voice chuckled somewhere beneath the earth, roaring the animal to fight harder. I ran towards them, knowing I had to stop them from killing each other, but I was running in slow motion. I knew I would be too late. I saw the eagle dive down its beak, aim at the horse's white eye, and I screamed, "No!" I woke with a start. Outside, it was really stormy. The kind of storm that cracked trees and blow down horses, houses. There was no horse, there's no eagle on the beach, but just lightning make a false daylight. And the 5 meter high waves pounding the dunes like artillery. Okay. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.